what is hard for people to really appreciate is how demanding this story was on so many levels, on a personal level, on a human level.
The proper response to it was that of disciplined professionalism to tell this story, even though it was breaking your heart as you told it.
I mean, some of this reporting was some of the most moving reporting I've ever done, you know, and I think all of us felt that way, that never have we been reduced to tears so often.
It was a foreign story, it was a national story, it was a metro story, it was a Washington story, it was all kinds of stories. And so it made sense to organize it.
This is not something that we had prepared for or developed a style for or developed standing features for. We were obviously starting this from scratch and just reacting to the news.
Al Siegel, who's in charge of style of the Times, had a piece of paper and he held it in front of me. He said, we've got this new section. Here are six potential names for it. And I ran down the list and I said, A Nation Challenged. So that's how much deliberation went into picking that title. I think I could have thought a long time and not come up with one that I like better.
Empty and aching and I don't know why.
And the funny thing is, people started noticing the New York Times has, you know, hey, the New York Times is suddenly a picture paper.
And what you found after a while was an incredible symbiosis, connectedness between the photographer and the correspondent.
Try not to worry. I have seen things that you will never see. Leave it to memory be. Don't dare me to breathe.
We kind of launched into the portraits of grief and started really by the seat of our pants writing these pieces. We were not looking for traditional obituary material. We wanted to get people to just open up. And what I found was the best way to do that was really not jump in and try and direct it in the way you would a traditional interview, but just sit and listen and respond and draw them out.
We experienced the most massive outpouring of reader response and approval and interest that I've seen in my 24 years at the Times and that others more senior than I have ever seen.
People talked about them with religious terminology and deep emotional responses that you do not expect to get in letters to the editor of a newspaper.
You can't lose sight of the uncertainty of the time after September 11th, what it meant to us as a city and what it meant to us as a nation.
We will do what is necessary to get the story before our readers.
It was such a sad, horrible period, and yet at the same time, it was juxtaposed with this extraordinary respect for the people that you were with. It's very hard to describe.